We are talking to boxing sensation Jessie Vargas. Jesse, you have a big fight on April 21st against Adrien the Problem Broner. You are the 2-division champion. He's a 4-division champion. What are your feelings about the fight?
Well, first of all, I mean, when I got the call about it, I accepted it. I had no doubts in my mind that I could beat Adrien Broner. But not only that, I felt that it would be a entertaining fight for the fans. You know, it would grab a lot of attention, and I was right. You know, my advisors, they thought the same. And thankfully, it's been getting a ton of attention, which is good for us. It's good for boxing. And I believe that we're going to give him a great night of boxing. I mean, Adrien Broner is a talented fighter himself, and I'm a very, very talented fighter myself. And we're going to give it all we have. That way we can give the fans a great performance on both ends. But I plan to come up victorious come April 21st.
Recently, I don't know if you saw this, Adrien told Keith Thurman, after I'm done with Jesse, I'm coming after you. What was your response when you saw that, and what do you tell Adrien?
You know what? It doesn't matter. The thing is that in boxing, you know, we can never look ahead from what's next, you know, from the next fight that's coming up for every fighter, every individual. And right now, I'm concentrated 100% on Adrien Broner. You know, of course, once I defeat him, then we'll plan ahead. But this is first, and this is serious business, and we have to really acknowledge that we have to prepare for it in the best manner possible. And if that's the way, I mean, you should definitely stay focused on this fight, because I have a feeling that I'm going to come out victorious. And, you know, I mean, I don't really put too much attention to it, though. Going back to your question, that doesn't matter to me. He likes to talk a lot, and we all know this in the boxing world. You know, he says things just to get attention from the people. You know, he can go ahead and talk crap to whoever he wants. At the end of the day, he has to face me April 21st. And it's not going to be a good night for him.
Who's the underdog? Is it Adrien Broner or is it Jesse Vargas?
You know what? The people seem to be gravitating towards both fighters, you know, myself and Broner, because they know it's an interesting matchup. You know, there's a lot of interest in this fight. Some people are debating who will win. A lot of people are on my side, you know, just because he does talk a lot. And I understand why they would think that. But you know what? At the end of the day, we're two fighters that we have to leave it all on the line and look for victory.
Both of you guys have very impressive resumes. You fight, no, not you and not Broner, step away from any challenge. What can we expect on fight night? Which Jesse Vargas, which Adrien Broner?
You're going to see fireworks, first of all. I mean, it's going to be an action-packed fight. We have a lot running on this fight, you know, and he's going to give it his all. I know that, and I'm glad that he will. That way there is no excuses after the fight. I'm going to give it my all also, and I plan to come out victorious. I mean, we both are fighters that are very versatile, and you might see a few different styles coming from him and I, you know, in order to adjust to what will take me to victory. But at the end of the day, it's going to be entertaining. The fans are going to love it. The fans are going to enjoy it. And come out. Don't forget April 21st. In New York, Brooklyn, New York, at the Barclays Center, all right? And if you can't go out to the venue, watch it on Showtime, I'm telling you, it's going to be fireworks. We have three very interesting fights. You have myself, Broner, of course, the main event, and then you have Charlo versus Hugo Centeno. It's a good matchup. You have Jay Lee on Love against Peter Quillen.
Gervonta Davis against Cuellar.
That's right.
Break down some of these fights on your card. Of course, your prediction for your fight with Broner. Let's start with that. What's the prediction?
All right. My prediction is Jesse Vargas wins me in a sensational victory. And as for the co-main, Charlo versus Hugo Centeno, that's going to be a war also. You know, we're going to have two very entertaining matches on the card. So don't forget. Tune in. Showtime. I can't call a winner on that one. It's a good fight. It really is. It depends who comes better prepared and who has the better game plan. And now as for Gervonta Davis and Cuellar, that's a good fight itself. Cuellar is a heavy puncher, and if he lands a punch on Davis, he can take him down. Davis is the younger fighter. He seems to be faster, more agile, but he can't get careless, because if he does, he will get taken down by a punch from Cuellar. And Jay Leon Love against Peter Quillen. Everybody knows Kid Chocolate. Stick with my boy Jay Leon Love. I see him winning. He's looking sharp in the gym. Man, I saw him spar the other day, and he's looking sharper than ever, so I'm looking forward to that one.
Now, Jesse, a few questions here. What does Adrien Broner do good in the ring, and what do you think you do better?
I mean, he's a very good counterpuncher. He loves to trash talk inside that ring. He does that well, too.
Does that bother you?
No, not at all. Okay. I mean, I grew up in this sport, and I've had all sorts of opponents in front of me. And that, I mean, I've had several fighters that came up and tried talking trash, and it never worked. And if that's what he's going to try to do, well, then bring it. You know, Saddam Ali also tried talking trash, and look at him now. So it doesn't matter who it is. He talks trash. His speed is very high. I mean, he is a fighter that has speed in his punches. He seems to have a little pop. He doesn't maintain his distance all that well. He tries to block his punches with his defense sometimes. I mean, just keeping his hands up in a peekaboo style and counter. He can take a shot. We do know that. So he has good qualities as a fighter, but I have better qualities. You know, I don't stand there and get hit. You know, I maintain my distance well if I want to. I fight the inside in an excellent fashion if I want to as well. I can attack the head. I can attack the body with vicious shots. I mean, and now I have the body snatcher with me, Mike McCullum. He's my trainer, and he's improving my style. You know, only bettering it for the better, and it's we're looking better than ever. I will assure you that. I'm glad to have Mike McCullum in my corner. He is a book of knowledge. He really is, and I think that you're gonna see a new and improved Jessie Vargas. I mean, my plan is to always continue to improve, no matter how old I am. We have to continue to better ourselves as a fighter, but I have very good pop, I guess, strength in my punches. I'm fast myself, and he's going to have complications with my speed also. I have a terrific right hand, terrific jab, hook. It doesn't matter what punch I'm going to hit him with. They're all going to hurt. I see myself as a better fighter, and I'm going to show it April 21st.
Another question I got to ask you here. So right now you're in camp. What's your routine pretty much every day? Are you doing two-a-days, three-a-days? I saw you stop by David Levy's place for some cryotherapy. What do you do?
That's right. We stop by Sub-Zero Recovery, of course. We can't live without that. You know, it helps me every day in my training camps be refreshed and rejuvenated for the following day. Of course, we do two-a-days. I think every fighter does at least two-a-days. I mix it up. Sometimes I do three. But Mike is really taking control over what I'm doing in camp, which I love. He's telling me, just slow down a bit. You know, today was a good day. You don't need to do any more. So he has control over what I'm doing, how many rounds I'm doing. And, I'm glad that I have a trainer that has control over me and that is showing me a way to improve my style, not only technically wise, but also in the accumulation of exercises and the momentum of how training camp is going. You know, he's controlling everything, which is very beneficial for me, because if you ask me, I say I can do five more rounds if you need me to. I can run five more miles if you need me to. There's no stopping me. But for a fighter, sometimes that's not always good. And I trust him. You know, he tells me, I mean, he had so much success. He's a fourth division world champion himself. And he tells me, Jesse, I fought 15 rounds, and guess what? This is how much I did. I ran this much, okay? I did this many rounds. Jesse, you're in terrific shape right now. We're gonna keep that rhythm going, but, you know, we're going to increase it as we go. We don't have to put so much right now. And once again, I'm lucky to have him in my team. You know, David Levy as well. My father is always with me no matter what. Ride or die, he's with me. And, I have my sister along with me in camp too. She's helping me out with several things. I have a team that I always have boasted about that is like family, and I'm glad that I have them along my side because I trust them 100%. Mike's a good guy. He's a book of knowledge.
Jesse, I'm going to remind people, because people in boxing sometimes have a very short memory. When you first turned pro, you were signed by Floyd Mayweather. You're one of his main stars before the current TMT guys. Have you ever sparred Floyd at that era?
No, I never sparred Floyd. I was the first one of the first fighters that he had, and we were very successful. We had great times together, but I never sparred him. I never asked to spar him. I never challenged him. You know, of course, you know, you're always interested as a fighter to go up against the best and to prove what you have also. But not only that, but to actually want to learn from someone that is known as the best fighter in the world. So, I mean, I always kind of, you know, I was up for the challenge. But I never wanted to disrespect Floyd, and then that's the reason why I never called him out. I never asked him for sparring, you know, if I could be one of his sparring partners, because he paid well all the time. But I just had too much respect for him to ever put myself in that position. So I never mentioned it.
Since the fight was announced, has Floyd talked to you? Because Adrien posted that he blocked Floyd. He's not taking his calls.
No, you know what? I was at his gym today, and I got to thank him for opening the doors to his gym, for letting me train in his facility. You know, that's where we're going to hold camp. We're going to hold camp in the Mayweather gym.
That's awesome. Yeah. You're home away from home anyway.
Exactly, man. We had so much success training out of that gym. And I really feel good and positive training there again. You know, I'm very comfortable.
Let me ask you about some upcoming fights. You have, of course, Linares, your friend. You're cool with everybody, but he's fighting Lomachenko. Tough fight. Lomachenko's a champion at 30, very talented. Linares a champion at 35. What do you think?
Oh, it's a good fight. You know, it's a good fight. You have one guy that has the advantage because he's the natural 135-pound fighter. You know, he's been there for several years. But we don't know how he's making the weight now, these days. You know, seems like he sacrifices a lot. And Lomachenko is a extremely talented fighter. That's a tough fight for the Venezuelan, but... you know, there's going to be fireworks May 12th. Technically wise, Lomachenko has the edge, but you have to understand that Linares also, he's more than natural 35-pounder. We just have to wait and find out.
A week before that fight is a major pay-per-view fight that made headlines just recently. Canelo Triple G. What do you make it a rematch, or what do you think, make it a news of Canelo? Look, he's taken hundreds of tests. He never failed a test. Failed this one. It happens, it shouldn't happen, but it happened. What do you make of all this?
It should never happen, you know, us as professional athletes, but sometimes under the circumstances, you know, we have to accept what's going on and really do our research. I haven't done the research behind Canelo, but he says that it must have been the meet in Mexico, if that's what he feels, and we have no prior experiences with him being caught with any type of illegal substances, then we should believe him. And if he's clean out, because I believe they tested him again and he's clean, then I can't call it. You know, I mean, the only reason I would blame someone is because if there's evidence and there's full proof that they were using illegal substances. But here, it seems to be explainable.
So who wins the fight, Triple G or Canelo, the rematch?
Man, that's a good fight. That's a good fight. The first fight, I thought Canelo won by a split edge, you know, by a round tops. I'm going to admit it. The only reason I thought it was because he was landing the most effective blows. He was landing the clear shots, you know. And of course, when it comes to Triple G, he threw a bunch of punches. He probably threw twice as much as Canelo threw, but he wasn't as effective. He didn't land all of them. He was just headhunting. You know, if I was Abel Sanchez, I would say, you gotta hit the body. The hit the body doesn't move. But he did not, and he missed a lot of punches, and that's why I thought that Canelo took it. You know, it was a crazy night, because everyone was saying, some were saying Triple G, some were saying Canelo, and I'm just thinking to myself, I can't say I'm an expert, but I do know my stuff when it comes to boxing. I saw Canelo just, his ring generalship showed a little more rather than an uncontrollable Triple G, just trying to headhunt. Now, in this next fight, it could happen the same way, but I think that now Triple G is going to be a little wiser. He's going to know how to pick his shots, to hit the body a little more, and that can make it dangerous for Canelo. But you just never know. I'm not sure, man. I mean, like I said before, in boxing, it's tough to pick a winner when a fight is that close. I guess... That one is more difficult than the Linares versus Lomachenko fight. If we go back to that, I would have to say Lomachenko. When it comes to Canelo and Triple G, I would have to say that it's just a tough fight. I can't call it. I mean, because I'd probably be wrong. You know, it's a close fight.
Okay, a couple more and I'm done.
What I would say is that I see Canelo going up, as in that could become a better fighter, and I see Triple G going downward as a fighter. You know, he's 30, I want to say 34 years old. He's a little older. Canelo's only 26, 27. And, you know, so that can play a big role in this fight, his age.
Okay, Anthony Joshua against Joseph Parker. I don't know if you know Joseph personally. I know he was in Vegas for a long time. Have you ever met him?
I've never met him. I think I've seen him once from a distance. And when it comes to the fight, I hear that he has a lot of talent. I hear that he can bring it. I've seen him fight against Andy Ruiz. He fought a tough fight with Andy. But I think that Anthony Joshua would win because of his height, his reach, you know, and his strength and mental fortitude, you know, gives him a slight edge. And I would say Anthony Joshua.
Okay, Joshua.
I didn't watch the Joshua versus Deontay Wilder. That's a good one.
Who wins that? I got Wilder, but that's just me. I don't...
Yeah, man, that's tough, man. It's whoever lands the first blow.
Okay.
Whoever lands the first blow is going down. I mean, his opponent is going down.
You fought Manny Pacquiao. It was a great fight. He's fighting. Yeah. It looks like he's fighting Lucas Matisse. Who do you think wins that one?
That's what they're saying. Lucas Matisse versus Pacquiao would have to say, yeah, Pacquiao takes it by decision. You know, he has tremendous speed, a lot of experience, much more experience than Matisse, and I think that both of those play a factor. I mean, we all know he has power, but I think speed and experience would just control Matisse.
We are exactly less than five weeks from your fight. What do you tell Adrien Broner if he's watching this video?
I don't have much to tell him. You know, get ready. Let's put on a great fight for the fans come April 21st. And I'll see you in April.
Okay, there you have it, Jessie Vargas. Tell everybody where to follow you on Twitter, Instagram, and all that, and Facebook.
Yeah, of course. First of all, I got to thank ESNews for the support. I got to thank all the fans for tuning in, for watching the videos. And follow me on Instagram, Jessie Vargas_, Jessie with an IE, Jessie Vargas_. Follow me on